Good morning, everyone. We'll continue the discussion on hydraulic fluids. Today, we are going to discuss about classification of hydraulic fluids. So, main classification of hydraulic fluids into two: mineral oil and fire resistant fluids. So, mineral oil, these are the features of mineral oil. These are the most widely used hydraulic oils because they are relatively inexpensive, easily available, and obviously offered in suitable viscosity grades, and they are chemically stable for appropriate reasonable operating range. But if they are used at very high temperature, they suffer breakdown. The disadvantages are the usage is limited below 1000 bar pressure, flammability and increase in viscosity at high pressure, fire risk when they are using in coal mines, molding machines or injection molding or near furnaces. But compared to the disadvantages, the advantages are more, and in most of the cases we can use mineral oils without any difficulty. Coming to the fire resistant fluids, suppose there are fire hazards in the hydraulic system or nearby, we may have to choose from these kind of hydraulic oils: oil in water emulsion, water in oil emulsion, depending on the oil water proportion, water glycol fluids, and synthetic oils. These are the different types of fire resistant fluids. So we'll see one by one. Oil in water emulsion. So, tiny droplets of oil is dispersed in a continuous water phase. So, there will be a water phase. Very small droplets of oil will be dispersed in the water. So, generally, as I told, it is rich in water. Only 2 to 5% of oil in water is a combination for oil in water emulsion. Very little amount of oil will be there in the water. It is extremely fire resistant because the major content is water, highly incompressible, and has good cooling properties because of, again, the high water content. So, as you are aware, water is a poor lubricant and it is having very low viscosity. Because of the higher water content itself, this oil in water type of hydraulic oil suffers from poor lubricity and low viscosity. Second type is water in oil emulsion. It's the most popular fire resistant fluid. They have a continuous oil phase in which tiny droplets of water are dispersed. So, water is dispersed in oil. So, oil content is more. So, the pumps are run at reduced speeds to cope up with the reduced lubrication properties. So, here the water oil proportion is 40-60. 60% of oil is dispersed in water. So the temperature should not exceed 25 degrees Celsius if the hydraulic oil used is water in oil emulsion. Okay. Third one is water glycol fluids. So, it was primarily developed for aircraft system, hydraulic systems, because of their lower flammability. Again, it cannot be used at very high temperature because of their high water content. Again, because of the higher water content, the lubricating ability is low. So, all these kinds are fire resistant fluid. Because of that, the water content is high. But they are very stable with respect to shear. They have good antifreeze properties. So obviously, they are suitable for low temperature applications. But they create adverse effect on paints. Synthetic oils have good fire resistant properties, lubricating ability similar to that of mineral oils, and it can be used in plastic molding and die casting industries. So the examples for synthetic oils are phosphate esters. So one of the examples. These are the superior qualities: thermal stability, oxidation stability, good viscosity index, low temperature fluidity, then operational temperature limits are quite good for almost all hydraulic applications, then good fire resistant property. So because of these features, synthetic oils are used in large nowadays for hydraulic applications. Now, as I mentioned in the previous session, we are discussing additives used in hydraulic oils in this section. Okay, so there are different additives to improve the properties of the fluids, like oxidation inhibitors, corrosion inhibitors, anti-foaming agents. So oxidation inhibitors improve the ability of liquid to withstand chemical reaction with atmospheric oxygen or air. We have already seen what will happen if the hydraulic oil is reacted with the atmospheric oxygen, right? So to prevent that chemical reaction of the oil with the atmospheric air or oxygen, oxidation inhibitors are added in appropriate quantity in the hydraulic oil. Similarly, corrosion inhibitors will form molecular layers that are bound to the surface of the hydraulic oil by electrostatic forces and form an effective barrier against penetration by oxygen and water. Only when oxygen or water are penetrated into the oil, the corrosion will happen, right? So the corrosion is prevented by such additives. Then anti-foaming agents. If you recollect it correctly, in the previous session, I have mentioned about the foaming, right? The property. So entrapped air in the hydraulic oil will come to the surface and it may form bubbles or foam on the surface, right? So these anti-foaming agents form small heterogeneous areas of low surface tension, results in bubble bursting. So these bubbles or air bubbles or foam on the surface will get bursted by the anti-foaming agents. These additives also could be added to improvise the property of a hydraulic oil. Anti-wear additives, viscosity index improvers, PowerPoint depressants. We have discussed about what is PowerPoint, friction modifiers, and last but not the least is the detergents, improving the cleanliness. To summarize the discussion on hydraulic fluids, the important characteristics or properties of the hydraulic fluids, I'll once again try to discuss. So a good hydraulic fluid should have these requirements, should have satisfactory flow properties through the entire range of operating temperature in which it is applied, very high viscosity index that ensures moderate viscosity variation in relationship to the temperature fluctuations, right? So flow properties, it is related to the PowerPoint. Then the second one is VI, viscosity index, variation of viscosity with temperature. Then lubricating properties, self-lubrication properties should be there. Then low vapor pressure to avoid cavitation. then the compatibility with all the materials with which it is coming in contact, chemical stability, unnecessary chemical reaction should not happen with any of the components, the material of the components, to avoid performance deterioration, and corrosion protection by appropriate addition of additives, then rapid deaeration and air separation in order to avoid forming, then thermal properties, thermal conductivity to rapidly dissipate the heat generated. Whenever the oil is flowing and there is moving parts, heat will get generated. So it should have good thermal conductivity to dissipate this heat generated. Otherwise, there will be a temperature rise and the viscosity may vary. Thermal expansion may happen. So many problems will arise. So it should have good thermal conductivity. Fire resistance. So appropriate fluid should be used depending on the application. Whenever there is, chances of fire hazards. Then electrically insulating properties can be significant in a number of modern designs where these hydraulic oils are in contact with the electrical components. Then very important property is the environmental acceptability. Should not cause any damage to the living atmosphere or environment. Okay, so we'll stop for today. We'll discuss the next topic in the coming session. Thank you.